about paradise?
Yeah.
This and that, that, this and that. What do you have problem with that?
What is my problem with the paradise? You cannot even imagine how much I am disturbed and how much I am upset the Islamic paradise Allah is offering to mankind. Here's my problem. As a Muslim, you just fasted during Ramadan. Today is one of your Eid, isn't it? You have 3 days of Eid. So, you were seeking for Allah, yet when you die, Allah is not going to be in paradise. He's not going to be there to have fellowship with you, even though you end up in the place of Allah. My problem is with paradise is, first of all, God, the Creator, does not even bother to spend time with His people. My problem for paradise is, I have been offered nothing as a woman in paradise. My second, third problem for the paradise is, it's a free Las Vegas. It's a place, that's not funny, it's a place where Muslims will go and then practice over and over, sex with the strangers who they don't know a lot about.
So, by
therefore,
the way,
I do not want to go to that paradise.
Okay. By the way, many people like to visit Las Vegas, by the way.
I don't.
Yeah, I said many people. But, so, you said paradise didn't offer you. Offer as a woman, there's nothing for a woman. And then you said God won't be in paradise. Where did you get those two from? There's nothing offered to a woman in paradise, and God won't be in paradise.
Have you finished?
Dad and brothers and women, who will get 100. What mean? What he will do with this 100 in the paradise?
Okay, let me respond. So, Amar, are you focused? Are you focused?
Yeah.
So, I just googled. You can google ticket to Las Vegas is £895. Okay? So, it makes sense. It makes sense. Lots of people wants to go to Las Vegas. It makes sense. People cannot afford to go to Las Vegas. So, I don't want to go to Las Vegas, which Allah is offering me, because I would love you to produce a verse from the Quran tells me what Allah is offering to women in Las Vegas. I cannot find a verse for that.
Okay.
That's the first one.
I want you to forget.
Let me finish. So that's the point I wanted to express it. Second point is I would love you ask me a question. Where did I get the idea that Allah is not going to be there? Christian scripture tells us in the beginning God was walking and talking with mankind. Christian scripture tells us at the end God is going to be with man and woman. Therefore, on my own desire in this world, even I seek for lots of things, I won't be satisfied. Only my desire can be satisfied in the place where I am blown, in the presence of Holy God. I would expect to see God in heaven, and Christian God is going to be in heaven to do fellowship with people. Christians are going to share the feast of Lamb of God. So, can you produce the verses from the Islam, which Quran, which tells me, let me finish, which tells me Allah is going to be there.
Okay, Allah is going to be there. Huh? That's your question. Number one, you didn't answer, you didn't respond to my point. There's a completely clear verse that says that any man or any woman who has done good deeds, believe in God, good deeds, he will go to paradise.
Where is it?
Go to chapter. Let me finish. Chapter.
No, give me your references. Let's break it down. You said
chapter
you bothered.
1, 2, 4.
So you said you bothered for last week's video. Now, I want you to break it down everything, okay, and then explain it to me. So, Surah 4 verse 124 tells you, people who does the good thing, good deeds, will go to paradise. Surah 4, verse 124. Let me read it. And I read it from verse 22. Okay?
124.
Yeah, I'm going to read it from verse 122. But once who believe and righteous deeds, we will admit them to gardens believe which river flows, wherein they will abide forever. It is the promise of Allah, which is truth, and who is more fruitful than Allah in statement. It, paradise, not obtained by your wishful thinking, nor by that of the people of the scripture. Whoever does a wrong will be recomposed for it, and he will not find besides Allah a protector or helper. And this is 124. And whoever does righteous deeds, whether male or female, while being a believer, those who will enter paradise and will not be wronged as speck on a date seed. So my question was to you, what is it waiting for me in paradise as a woman?
So you agree now?
Just a moment. And then you gave me the verse,
No. You say what is offered to you as a woman.
Yeah, what is waiting for me in paradise.
Exactly,
yeah.
As a woman.
Yeah. So you gave me the verse which says, if you do your good deeds, men and women are going to go to paradise.
Exactly.
So
whether you're a man or woman,
yeah,
is good.
As we are clear, that doesn't answer my question. Sir, does it answer my question? No.
Nothing answering your question.
It doesn't.
Well,
yeah, why not? Why
could maybe
he
right.
Had a,
yeah.
He had a whole week. He had a whole week to prepare. So
my problem is,
I'm gonna break it down. My question was, what is it waiting for me in paradise? This verse just tells you your good deed is going to take you to paradise. Yes, we know.
Okay, now I understand.
And we know from Islamic tradition, Muhammad says, your good deeds are not going to save you. So there is a contradiction on it. But I'm not going to go to that because we know topic is the paradise.
Exactly.
So what is waiting for me as a woman in paradise?
The Quran talk about paradise. That's the only book in any scripture, in any religion, that clearly tells you what is going to happen in the day of judgment. How people will be standing, how people will be judged, what people will talk about. And the only scripture that talk about the completely details about hellfire. Completely details about hellfire. How they will enter hellfire, how they will live there, what language they, whatever is happening in hell is described in the Quran. The only scripture that completely give you details of paradise, what is waiting for you there, completed. You cannot see that in the Old Testament, in the New Testament, in any statement.
So yes. Her question is,
so
the question
is, so,
no, woman and man in paradise.
Omar, just a moment. I can see you took whole week to bother about the video we put up last week, but you failed to focus.
I didn't finish.
You failed to focus the essential points. My question was a very simple question. What was my question? Tell us.
What is waiting for a woman in paradise?
What is waiting for me? Okay. So far you told us there is a hell and all other things.
No.
Quran is the book which talks all about.
No. You have to respect each other. Listen to each other.
I don't want you to waste your time. Hell and heaven are very serious things.
Okay.
I want you to answer the direct question in a simple method.
I will know.
What is it waiting for me as a woman in paradise?
Why I say that? Because what is waiting for you is completely clear in the Quran. It's completely clear. What in the Quran, there is not this woman or this man. They are called people who believe in God and then do the good deed, they will go in heaven. Whatever a man got there, a woman will get. Whatever a woman will get there. There's a place of justice, a place of everyone is welcomed, God is happy with everyone. All the pleasures we were talking last week is in the Quran. Even the sex things you are mentioning is in the is in paradise for everyone. It's a place of enjoyment. Place of enjoyment. Everything that your soul desire will be in paradise. Anything that your soul desire will be in paradise. We do not know all the things that our souls desire. Every day we find out our souls desire like something we didn't know. You can go to a restaurant which you have never been. Example, I can go to a restaurant, let's say a Chinese restaurant or Indian. I find a food there which I love. I didn't know that food exists. God said anything that your soul desire will be in paradise. Anything.
Let me respond. My question was, what is it waiting for me in paradise? You said whatever I am desire. And
your
it breaks my heart that you compare that desire as an Indian restaurant or any other shop. It is sad in a sense, your paradise kind of five class version of Indian restaurant.
I can see.
In a sense, you are thinking paradise.
Desire, what your soul desire. No, I give the example of food.
Let me finish. I let you to speak.
And
wait, I'm gonna come to that. I can see. Your hecklers are not being very helpful. Here's the thing. So, as you compare Las Vegas to Indian restaurant, I'm going to compare your paradise to Las Vegas. You said you get in paradise, as if I make the paradise as a woman, because I acknowledge Islamic scripture teaches your good deeds are not going to save you, as Muhammad teaches in Sahih Bukhari. I acknowledge Muhammad makes a claim majority of women are going to be in hell because they are deficient in their mind. Reason for that is they get their periods. I want to tell you, as a woman, okay, if I am Muslim, sake of the argument, if I was a Muslim, my desire would be being with God Himself. Because in this world, I seek to come more close to God. My desire is in paradise. I want to have a fellowship with God. I want to have dinner with God. I want to eat from the feast. In the paradise. Am I going to get God in paradise? That's okay. Simple yes
okay.
or no question.
Okay, in paradise, I was saying your soul desire. Only God spoke that word, not me. Only God knows what our soul desire. What I'm saying, every day we are finding things which our souls desire, which we didn't know. So God said everything that your soul desire will be there. Rivers of milk, rivers of water, rivers of honey, there's fruit, all kinds of fruit. It's a place, there's no sadness, there's no fatigue in it. It's the best place. So God will be with you in paradise. The best reward in paradise, you will see God. Because in Islam, we do not have any picture, any description of God, because we believe God is not a created thing. So in paradise, the veil that God put between us and him, in this world we cannot see God. God will remove this veil. You will be able to see God.
So I would love you to back that up, okay? I would love you to back it up where I am going to see God. Remember, my question was, I don't want to get the glimpse of God in paradise. If paradise is the place, currently Las Vegas is the place where Allah is gonna be. Can I have a fellowship with him? Yes and no question. That's a very simple question. And you said whatever your soul desire. If I am desired for shish kebab, am I gonna get shish kebab in paradise?
Anything that your soul desire.
If I am desired for biryani, am I gonna get biryani in paradise? If I am desired for lamb curry, I am gonna get a lamb curry in paradise. If I am desired for a vegetarian curry, am I going to get a curry? Is your Allah the paradise he made? It looks like it's Marks and Spencer in Las Vegas.
Okay.
So I would love you to prove everything from your sources, which tells you I'm gonna get all those lovely food I am asking, because probably by the time I get to paradise, I will be longing for hot chocolate. Am I gonna get hot chocolate? Am I gonna get a beer in paradise? Please give your reference.
By the way, the definition, the quotation, the proof you needed is in Surah 23, chapter verse 23.
But read it.
The Quran.
Let me read the verse. Can you come a little bit this way? Surah 23, verse 23. Should answering my question, what is it waiting for me in paradise?
No, no, you said that you want to be with God. Okay. I said you see God.
Surah 23, verse 23, should be showing God is going to be there. Let's read it. And we had certainly sent Noah to his people. And he said, oh my people, worship Allah. You have no deity other than him. Then will you not fear him? Surah 23, verse 23, has nothing to do with what I asked you. Give me the right reference.
No, sorry. It's 75:23. I made a mistake. 75:23.
So question is, what is it waiting for me in paradise?
No.
Is God,
you deny that God,
is God going to be in paradise? Surah 75 verse 23. It's only short verse. I'm going to read it a little bit from the top.
I read
it from verse, let's say, 17. Indeed, upon us is its connections in your heart and to make possible its recitation. So when we have recited it through Gabriel, then follow its recitation. Then upon us is its clarification to you. No, but you, mankind, love the immediate and live the hereafter. Some faces, the day will be radiant.
I'm not
looking
asking you
at
to read that.
Their Lord. Looking at their Lord. And some faces that day will be contorted. So that day has been translated throughout Islamic tradition is the day of resurrection, day of judgment. Is Allah going to be day of judgment? Yes. God is going to be the one who is judging. My question was, is it?
No, Jesus is God.
My question was to you, is God going to be in paradise or not? This verse does not show that. This verse talks about the day of judgment. This verse talks about the day of judgment.
So why do you have problem? Look at here. You have problem having sex in paradise. Why do you have problem with that?
Yeah. Why do I have a problem with the sex in paradise?
By the way, you are not the only one who have this problem. Many people make videos about this sex in paradise. You hear this? What is the problem? I don't see any problem there.
Okay, here's the heartbreaking thing. Amen. Look at my eyes, please. Do you seriously not see there is a problem having 100 sex in one day in paradise?
Having sex in paradise is a problem.
You don't see that as a problem?
No.
Okay. So,
what is the problem? You tell me the problem.
Let me tell you what is the problem.
Problem of?
Is there a problem?
Having sex.
One man having sex with 100 women in paradise.
What is the problem? There's no problem.
In paradise, there's no marriage.
Sorry. Here's the most heartbreaking part. Most heartbreaking part. Can you hear how you broke my heart?
Maybe I did, but
just
you will have sex in paradise if that is going to break your heart.
Just telling him, one man thinks there is no problem to having sex with 70 women in paradise and says there is no problem. Here's the thing. So far you provide.
I'm asking, what is the problem having sex in paradise?
I am answering the question. So far you already pointed out that current Max and Spencer version which in Las Vegas is your shopping center in paradise. I don't want to go there. I want to be in a place where I am in a fellowship with my creator, which we confirm Islam does not offer. Now, your next question was, what is wrong with having sex in paradise?
What is the wrong?
Here's the thing. Man is going to get, first of all, there's a couple of problems. First one is, it's unfair. It's unfair to woman. Woman cannot have 72 virgin men to have sex, and it is unfair for men to able to have sex with 70 women in paradise who looks like a bit extra scared. Beside all those things,
there's no problem.
Let me finish. I haven't finished. People in this world are not made for sex. In the beginning, Islamic tradition would agree with me. Allah did not create it, men and women to have sex and then have sex and then have sex with one another. It wasn't your original desire. Yet, Allah is giving you the Las Vegas. What is wrong with having sex? Over 70 women in paradise, you are getting 100 women, 70 of them virgin, all those kind of things. What is wrong with that? Scripture tells us, Christian scripture tells us, God made men and women, husband as a husband and wife, for one another until the end of their life. You become one flesh, according to Christian scripture. This happens in marriage. But Islam steps in, and then suddenly introduces 70 different flesh, because the things God didn't want in this world ends up in paradise as a Las Vegas getting room. Which is wrong. So, first of all, respond to the how many virgin woman is gonna get, and respond, virgin man of course, respond. I'm gonna talk to him when I finish speaking. Can you just tell him?
100 women. For me, you haven't talked to the subject. I'm asking where the problem having sex there. You are telling me. It's my turn. I'm not asking a question.
Can you just tell me what was my response?
Your response is about fatigue. How can a man have sex with all those people in paradise?
That was my response.
So he's not able to do that.
It wasn't my response.
So why is your...
You didn't listen. My response.
You are talking about paradise. You're talking about this world. I'm just asking you.
What is
your problem having sex in paradise?
Okay, let me respond that again. Can you please open your ears and listen what I'm saying?
Okay.
Here's the problem. First problem. In the beginning, man and woman, husband and wife, one man, one woman, identified husband and wife, they are made for one another. Okay? Therefore...
This is this world we are talking about. I'm talking about paradise. Paradise is not this world.
Omar, in the garden, when Allah created Adam... When Allah...
Forget about the world. We are talking about hereafter. We are talking about paradise. What is your problem having sex in paradise? Not in this world.
My problem, sir, it goes God's original plan according to Christian scripture. It questions the morality of Allah, who doesn't allow you to have sex with 70 wife in this wife. Can you cover? He's just screaming in my eye. He's just screaming in my ear.
I need to play.
So heckling doesn't have, and heckling just shows how Islam is very, very low. Here's the point.
You're not my question.
My problem is
in paradise.
My problem is first, in the beginning, sex takes place between one and woman, okay? But in paradise, you are having sex as you are in Las Vegas. That's the first problem, according to Islamic tradition. You are not having sex with your wife, but you are having sex with 70 strangers, and even you can have sex with lots of wives. I am not talking about there is a fatigue or not, because I read from the Islamic tradition, I read it from the Islamic tradition. Islamic tradition tells you Allah is going to make your penis so strong that you will able to have sex with 70 women. You will be that powerful enough. I'm not talking about the footed part of it. I'm talking about the moral side of it. And still, you have not answered my question regarding what, how many person, woman is gonna get sex while man is having sex with 70 people.
So you agree with me, human being will have sex in paradise, but you don't agree.
Just a man. What is it I'm agreeing with?
No, let me finish. Agree with me, a man and a woman will have sex in paradise.
According to Islamic tradition.
What you don't agree, a man having sex with many women in paradise. That you don't agree. I'm glad you agree. At least man and woman will have sex in paradise.
According to Islamic tradition, yes.
You don't believe in that?
According to Islamic tradition,
okay.
Yes.
Okay. According to Christian...
According to Islamic tradition, yes.
According to Christian sources, there won't be sex in paradise.
According to Islamic tradition...
Is that what you're saying?
Sir, according to Islamic tradition, man and woman is going to have sex. Let's talk about the numbers. Let's talk about the morality of this.
Okay,
and then tell me the numbers of the virgin man.
I don't have any problem with that. I believe man and woman will have sex. If you don't believe that, so if you have to prove where is the wrong of that. Because one of the enjoyment human being love is sex. God made sex for two reasons. To enjoy it and to get baby, to procreate. That's the two reasons. God could have made it just for babies. No, you don't enjoy it. You just, whenever you want baby, you have sex with a baby. You don't feel anything enjoyment. You could have just made it just for enjoyment, no baby. But he made both. Because sometimes people have sex. Man and woman, when they get together as wife and husband, they got sex, even if it's not for kids. But because there is enjoyment, they like it. God made that like that. We are saying in paradise, there will be women, there will be men, there will be sex. There was no problem with that. And there is not like here, there is not like illegal sex and legal sex. Because God made illegal sex and legal sex in this world. In paradise, God allowed for man and woman to have sex without no sin, because there is no sin, there is no blame in paradise. God will be happy for people in paradise. He will never punish you, he never get angry with you. There's nothing wrong with that. If you are telling me there won't be a sex, I will ask you, will God resurrect our private body part or not?
Let me respond. So there are lots of things going on in that. First of all, you don't see there is a problem having sex, 100 women versus one man. You don't see that.
There is a problem just, because our bodies Mama, will be
let
perfect.
Let me finish. So, of course you want to go to that paradise because you were just having sex with 100 women in one day. Let's work out some of the practical things on that, okay? So, you did not answer my question. How many husbands or how many virgin men, if it is virgin man, woman is gonna get when she enters the paradise after being not intelligent, all that junk? Give me the numbers and then we do some comparative. I don't know the numbers. How many?
You don't have the problem about having sex
in
paradise. The problem is too many, Omar, listen. Don't worry,
listen.
You will be able to handle it. God will resurrect the human being as a strong body. We won't get fatigued, we won't get tired, we won't get sickness, we won't die. That's the, our bodies will be a perfect body.
Let me just read it from the hadith and then you see what Allah is promising you.
It's a place everyone wants
and
to
there
go.
Is no one whom Allah will admit to paradise, but Allah will marry him to 72 wives. Two from Huris, heavenly wives, and 70 from inheritance from the hellfire. All of whom will be desirable from passages, and he will make a male member, that's his penis, that never becomes fallacy, which means soft or limp. So as you have sex with 72 wives, yes, you are correct.
Yes,
Islam is teaching.
Yeah, I agree.
Islam is teaching.
Now.
You will be strong enough to have sex.
No, that's not Islamic teaching. Even Christian is teaching.
Omar,
your body
I
will be a
you.
Perfect body.
I
your
will
body
be listen.
Won't be sickness or fatigue or tiredness. Your body will be the perfect body for eternal life.
With
our flesh, our flesh now is not for eternal. That's why we have this sickness, this tiredness, this worries, this bad behavior, this sadness, this cries. In paradise, we no more. I
so
agree with that.
As the Sahib, as the tradition tells us, your private part is always gonna be hard, so you will able to have sex.
Not
with,
only your private, all your body.
72 virgins.
No, no. Your body will be strong.
Omar, listen, I'm speaking to you, that's very, very disrespectful, okay? So, can you first, for me to move on to the next topic, can you just tell me, as men get 72 virgins, how many virgins does woman get?
Okay, now it's all about...
No.
Just, I will tell you.
I will tell you. Thank
God
you.
God bless me as well, innit?
Oh. Can you tell me?
God bless all of us.
So I'm going to make my point, but before I make my point, I need you to give me the number. How many virgin woman is going to get?
Okay, you see, I'm happy you agree there will be sex there. But you are worried.
According
you
to
won't get, you won't get many, many men as
how many?
That,
I'll answer your question.
Yeah. If man will get that, you probably got the same number. Because
so
it's a prayer.
So it's going to be the same number.
Yeah, probably.
So, let's speak.
The hadith talk about men here.
Where is the hadith which tells you woman is going to get 72 husbands as well?
I said probably. I didn't
so
say there's
don't
a
know.
Hadith that say that.
There is a hadith. There
I
is
don't
a
know
hadith.
About hadith that say that.
Omar,
but
listen.
If there's a hadith and the hadith is correct,
Omar.
I will accept it.
Omar. Practice your listening skills. So, hadith tells you man, hadith doesn't promise woman is gonna get 72 virgin men. I would like you to, first of all, to produce the hadith which tells you that's what I'm gonna get, okay? So, here's the practical tips. How many minutes, I'm sorry for the language I'm speaking, how many minutes does it take for man to have sex with a woman?
Okay, in this world, in this world, there's some men which are strong and some
give
women
me the times.
Which are stronger. So they can last longer. They can
give
enjoy
times.
Themselves longer.
Give me time.
But sometimes
give me the
they
time.
For some reason, for fatigue or depression depression. Let me, I'm coming.
Just give me the
you
time.
You told me to practice to listen.
Just give me the time. Just answer the question by giving me time.
What I'm saying here, you're asking a question. People are different. Some people
average.
Are very strong. No, some people are very strong. They can last longer. Some are not for different reasons.
When
no
you
reason
say
might,
they, when you say they
here,
last longer, how many minutes or how many hours do you
I don't know how many minutes. I don't know. Probably 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes.
Okay, let's
depend
go.
But
let's
why
go.
I tell you?
Just what? A moment. Sorry, Omar, let me make my point. So, have you got phone, sir, with you?
Sorry.
Okay, I've got phone. So.
But what is for sure?
So, that's fine. Omar, I'm just gonna make my point and then we see from there, okay?
Yes.
So, best according to conversation so far, longest sex is 15 minutes. Is that what we are saying?
I said
5,
I said men are different.
Okay,
I don't want to give you number here.
Let's say strongest man, how long is it for him?
Yeah, I don't want to give time because I watched the program.
Omar.
There's a woman who was saying she goes out with different men. She was saying what she saw so far is a sportsman. People practice sport like footballers. They always are moving their bodies. They can last longer.
Okay.
This is a woman I watched
so,
the program.
Okay.
And then they realize,
let me be very generous, okay? And then I'll go with your numbers. You said 15 minutes.
I said probably
15 minutes.
Different.
Okay.
Maybe more. maybe 1 hour. It's different. People are different.
Let's go.
I don't want to talk about you. My personal. What else I will tell you something?
Omar. Average 15 minutes according to your best, longest, from the strongest man. Okay? So, one day is 24 hours. Which is 60 minutes in each hour. That makes 1,440 per day. 1,440 minutes per day. Okay? So, divide that to 15 minutes. That makes 96.
What?
Okay? That means
96 minutes.
Yeah. Without any break, without any changing from one bedroom to other bedroom. With this 15 minutes sex, you can have sex with 96 women in one day in paradise.
You
okay?
See?
Allah is proposing you
okay.
In one of the hadith 72, in another hadith up to 100 women.
Okay.
Let me finish. As you have sex 96 times a day, what else are you going to do in that day?
Okay. The problem is...
How disgusting is that mathematical problem?
This is my turn now.
Issue?
I listen to you. Listen to me a bit as well. You are calculating this because your mind is still talking about this world. I'm telling you, in paradise, you will never die. In heaven, you will never die according to your religion. You will be a perfect body. But there's no fatigue. It's the best place. Having sex 90 minutes. Some people do it here 1 hour. One hour or more.
Number of people.
Huh?
Number of people.
Okay. Omar, this is getting disgusting.
Even 1,000.
This is getting disgusting.
No. It's not disgusting.
Let me finish.
Our books. Our Quran told you. That's why I tell you. There is a completely clear about paradise. No, this. We are not shy to talk about this.
Yeah.
God is not shy to tell us what is going to happen in paradise and hell. We can't stand here talking about. People don't want to talk about sex. They think it's funny. Things. We all are here because our parents got married. It's a fact. Whether people like
so,
it or
not. Here's the point.
You won't get tired in heaven. Even if
Here's the point. There is a morality question. Okay? I ask you, how many men, virgin, woman is gonna get in paradise? First of all, is woman gonna get a man in paradise? Hadith is silent. Is woman gonna get virgin woman in paradise? Hadith is silent. If woman is gonna get virgin woman, there is an improper action is going on in paradise. And according to numbers you have given me, you are telling me man will be strong enough to have sex.
Yeah, your body.
96 times.
All your body.
96 times.
Because you are not dying, you are out of the picture.
And as you talk about it, it seems you are very, very proud of it. But as you explain it to me little bit, I get more disgusting about it, I get more sickened about it, and I have got nothing to do with this paradise.
That's my turn now.
Let me give you my questions. Let me give you my last questions and then we finish.
No, you don't finish because I need to ask you something.
What is it waiting for women in paradise besides watching their husbands to go around and sleep with strangers? Besides seeing their friends or relatives being used for sex? What is it waiting for women? That was my first question. My second question is why I cannot have fellowship with God while in this world I am desire for my God, yet he's not gonna be there.
Okay, what I'm trying to tell you, we will be resurrected according to your teaching, according to your Bible. We won't die again. So why God will resurrect our private part in heaven? In heaven, why? If God will not resurrect our private part, why he won't? If he will resurrect our private part in heaven, where you are going to, with our private part dead, what is the reason we have our private part? Why is not working? Because according to both our teaching, you and me, we will be fully resurrected, every single part of our body. Exactly. The Quran talks about your eyes will be resurrected. You believe in that because there will be a purpose for resurrecting your eyes. You will see what is going on in heaven. You will be able to talk. God will resurrect your mouth because you will be able to communicate.
You will be able to have
so God will resurrect our private part. That will be a purpose for something else. But what I'm telling you here is you got to prove me why God will resurrect our private part in heaven. Where you believe whoever takes Jesus as Lord and Savior will go. If the private part will be left in the grave, why? Are we going to be all men in paradise or are we going to be all women? What sex will be in paradise?
Let me conclude.
You got a problem. No.
Let me conclude. Here's the thing. I get more disgusting as you talk about how Allah is going to make you perfect, especially your private part. While Allah makes you... Omar, let me finish.
Let me finish.
Allah is going to give you perfect body, okay?
Yeah.
With the perfect private part including in that body. Isn't that perfect body? We have a perfect brain. And that perfect brain is going to tell Allah, tell Muhammad, something wrong in these teachings. While you are offering me to have sex 96 times a day without any break. My perfect brain tells me, since you are resurrecting me in a perfect way, my perfect brain tells me there is something wrong. I do not want to be in this Las Vegas, free version of Las Vegas.
By the way, there is no day in paradise, there is no night in paradise.
You might say that, but Hadith tells us in one day you will be able to have sex with 100 women.
Hadith tells us. Why God resurrected our private part?
I haven't finished.
Why? According to you, why?
I have not finished.
You have to prove why God has resurrected
human body part. If you listen, I will answer the question. This is my conclusion anyway. So, as Allah gives you perfect body with perfect private part, in that perfect body, you will have perfect brain. Gonna tell Allah, something is wrong with you. I am designed for you, not 400 women. I am not designed for 72 virgins who will be virgin after again. So, now
let me respond.
What
man and woman will do in paradise?
Yeah, let me respond.
Because there will be men and women. What are they going to do in heaven? Where are you going to?
Yeah.
Tell me, I'm going to respond. Like.
I am going to respond. Just give me time. Here's the bottom line. With your perfect body, with that perfect brain, you will be questioning the morality of Allah. And as you question the morality of Allah, my prayer is that you will never end up in free Las Vegas. Here's what Bible says.
Okay. I'm happy to hear what the Bible
says. Now, the dwelling of the God is with man, and he will live with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, no mourning, no crying or pain, for all order of things have passed away.
So is that the only thing you do in paradise?
Bible tells us.
That's the only thing. By the way, I agree with this.
I
agree because I said that earlier in Revelation. By the way, the Bible is not clear what is going to happen in hellfire, what is going to happen in paradise. You are using this revelation. You don't know. Jesus did to you? What are you going to get in paradise?
I want to hear what Jesus said. I do not want to go to the paradise which offers free Las Vegas. I'm gonna go to the place heaven. Which Bible offer me, offers
where
me
is that?
Identified as the
where
house of God, as the paradise. Bible tells us
where?
God was
Black
in
bull.
The beginning.
Black bull.
God was in
Las
the beginning, man and woman. And that God is going to be with man and woman at the end. That's what I am desired
you
for.
You don't have
I am looking
religion.
Forward to having that day.
Okay, why?
And I am grateful to God. I am grateful to God. I am grateful to God that he is willing to
you can't
have
answer
me
that question.
In his paradise. And that is the paradise I am given because that is
Jesus
the heaven
never
I am given because
clear about
all
paradise.
The blood
the Old
of Lord Jesus Christ.
Will you have fruit
so
in paradise?
You need to reproach.
Just have a look at that.
Will you
when
eat?
You, when you leave this place, please have a look. It's about, it'll make you laugh.
Okay.
Will you eat in paradise?
So, I will eat in paradise from the feast of Lamb of God. So,
you are going to have barbecue there.
For you to, for
you, see,
you to come
you
to paradise.
With me. You agree
for
with
you to
me.
Come to paradise.
You are going to eat, enjoy.
Heaven, which Bible describes, you
why
need to
God,
repent from your sins.
Why God resurrected
our Lord Jesus
back,
as your Lord and your Savior.
Why God
that will allow. That will allow.
Why
you
God
to come
resurrect
and
our private
spend your eternity
in
with God himself. I'm done with this topic.
What is the reason?